What's going on, guys? It's me, Hawksy, back again for some more mini EDM, EP, and album reviews. Everything in this video is from between April 1st and June 30th. Anything before or after that, not in this video. Everything from January and March 2022 was in the last video, which I'll have linked somewhere, I bet. Anyway, enjoy this. Everything is going to be linked in the description, and there'll be timestamps on the video. It's the same structure as last time. Just hopefully a bit more personality. So yeah, just enjoy the video, guys. Kicking off our first EP of the second episode is Zach Gray's EP. It's called What It Used To Be. Released on Lost In Dreams, and it's okay. I didn't feel a ton from it, but it isn't bad. Its problem is that it's not very unique. And I think that in that style, I think that's becoming so common, you know, your Crystal Skies, your all that, like, that they're the names that come to mind when I think just this style. The vocals are actually pretty good, though. I will give it credit for that. I do like the vocals, and the acoustic at that end of our EP was really nice, but Never Get Like You is my favourite. I think it has a bit of a darker tone, so that's the one that stood out to me. This project just solidifies to me that Half-Hard Project is a label that you just really need to take seriously. This album just has some huge tunes, especially at the beginning with tunes from Lunar Sun, Chala 78, and the Secrecy and In Case collab. All three are different styles. You've got some color bass, drum and bass, which sounds like color bass, as well as Chala 78 just going for the change of style between the beginning and the electro kind of drop was really awesome. Cosmic Latte's tune, that was really cool, more color based kind of stuff. Styx, Eloquence, and Virtual Safari's collab was certainly interesting. It was not at all what I expected. And Sandro, Splitter, and Codra's collab went really hard. It's hard to pick a favorite, but Lunar Sun might honestly take this one out. Otherwise, this was a really good compilation. Half Heart Project is a label you really need to look out for. Squad returns with a new Basshouse EP called Your Soul. It's pretty good. I like Basshouse, obviously. Impactful tunes, like every tune hits hard, hits the mark. It's nothing over the top though. It all hits the mark to me. There's five songs, two of them I found were catchier than the others, Your Soul and Down On Me were those two. Not massive standouts, but I think standouts in their own right, they have that replay value, and yeah, I think this whole EP has replay value, honestly, but it's an acquired taste for sure. I had a few expectations for Wishlane's EP about the style it was going to be in, but I wasn't sure what the quality would be like or whether I'd just like it in general. The quality was impressive. This is a lot better than I imagined. I love the vocals. The vocals in every song was really good. No song has any glaring issues at all, really. Like, I don't have anything negative to say. Super clean production. I'd say Kalsamine was probably my favourite song. I probably said that wrong, or my accent, who knows. I found every song it was their own journey, but yeah, this one song just got to me a little bit more than the others. But in saying that, I'm glad I checked this EP out. I wasn't going to, and I was like, stuff it, I'll do it. And it was absolutely worth it in the end. Highly recommend. Kind of pains me to say this, but I didn't find any song on this really amazing, to be honest. I didn't find that compilation really had a lot of stuff going on. Like, I like the premise and why Hex is starting the label, like promoting those artists, absolutely, that's what I love. I'd love to be able to do that too, but I didn't have nothing really blew me away on this album, and it was kind of surprising. I thought I would enjoy some tunes. The highlights for the album, Bendel's tune, Lizdek, Mako, and Inhuman had a good song, Code Pandorum's old alias, and Yash Banzel as well, but I didn't add anything to any playlists. I didn't find the compilation quality amazing, but in its own right, the premise for the album's there, so yeah. Samplify went damn hard on this EP. Really liking this one. Everything just is produced so fucking hard. Like, it's ridiculous how hard this one goes. Everything here is Even the company collab, I don't think that was amazing, but I think that was pretty good. Like, it's all hard-hitting. So there's a few tracks on here which I think surprised me to be my favourite. My favourite was Hell. I'm not sure if that's a crazy take or not, but that Leave is really fun to listen to. And the grittiness in Harold as well. I really like that one. That would probably be my second favourite. But regardless, I actually really like this. Why don't you give me a real challenge? I'm not even sure why I listened to this, but sure, here you go. This EP released on Subsidia. That's it. It released on Subsidia. It sums it up completely. It's just really mediocre and boring dubstep. Not every tune falls flat. Production is weak. Evolution is an annoying song. Like, it's actually just annoying. Only okay song was probably Falling when it gets to the color based sections, but yeah, that doesn't save the EP at all. This is definitely my least favorite on the entire video. It's ridiculously bad. When you say it is Mute, I'm not gonna bother. The Gift of Dying EP, one of the better Roundtables EPs that I can remember. A promising alias for sure. Each song just, it sounds so crisp, honestly, in its own way. Unique ideas and a style which I think could become a staple for this alias and a staple for dubstep in general, really. It's really looking promising. Black Belly and also Patron Saint. Patron Saint were my favourite two songs. I think Black Belly stands out the most, but yeah, Patron Saint's another good song. Yeah, really liking this one. Not often do I not make an individual video about a Disciple main release, but I saw Virus Syndicate and I thought, I'm not sure about this. I stood corrected. Nothing really I loved in the EP. Wasn't horrible, wasn't great, nothing bad, nothing great. Yeah. A few different styles though. Got some color base in there with a bit of Ace Aura and whatnot. Different names, Heritage was on there too. My favorite on the whole entire EP was actually the Wales collab. Really shocked me this is my favorite, because Wales dubstep is usually a big miss, but this one actually, yeah, I really liked how it flowed and it ended up being my favorite on the EP. Probably could have made a video about Swedish House Mafia, but I thought I'd just leave it in this video. What a comeback. It's been like 10 years and they finally come back. And yes, they had their debut album. Thanks Bowtie for that one. It's a really grand return, but it has a different style, such as the house or something. Some really well-renowned features, like Sting is on this, like why is Sting on it? Who cares? Anyway, the whole thing's a true experience. There's a few tunes I like, Calling Out, really good tune. I like how it flows. Red Light with Sting, as I said. It's the hardest hitting one on the album, and it's probably one of the more fun songs. But the best song in the album, like, if it isn't just Moth to a Flame, what else is it? Like, Moth to a Flame is just an incredible tune. The Weeknd is just an outstanding artist, and really just rounded out. It really rounds out this whole entire album. But yeah, Moth to a Flame is just awesome. Another new Equity compilation. It's about time we got another one, and this one is Seventh Heaven Volume 1. This compilation was another one that didn't blow me away. Much like Alter Ego, this one didn't really do a whole heap for me either. But there's some crazy talent on it, some names that I don't recognize, as always. There's a fair few unmemorable tracks though, really. Good production, not incredibly gripping ideas, a few songs that like we're all right, but yeah, it hurts me to say that because I really love Equity and I love the people there. They're awesome. Makino and Clay Keir's song was, they killed it. They just absolutely got the energy of the whole song right. And Neat always releases a class tune as well. Neat's song was really good too, but yeah, Makino and Clay Keir really, really won this one over for me. But yeah, hopefully the next album comes out pretty soon. I don't really want to see Volume 1 and then just never for it to be finished. It's the same with Reflections. I hope their Reflections series comes back too. Holy moly, this this is actually a mental as EP, as stated in the title. And Underbelly's Mental Kill EP is just crazy cool. It's so different, and it's exactly what the Halcyon label really stands for, honestly. They've got a really big hit inside of this one. Underbelly's really showing their potential and their talent on this EP, and I think they're really a name that everyone has to look out for with this, because it's just so different. Like, their styles are dubstep, but just in general EDM, it's just so cool. There's so many different segments to each song. It's just like, wow. My favorite was Matches. Matches was my favorite song. It's pure and simple. It's just insanity. You've got to listen to this EP from start to finish, because I saw some rave reviews and I didn't know what to expect, but checked it out for myself, and man, it's like not even a style I usually listen to, but it's just done to perfection. So I hope those words do enough to convince you to listen to this, because it is amazing. Lewis the Child is just the perfect representation of EDM meets pop. Every track on this EP is just so damn fun. There's different styles, an awesome variety of vocals. I just find the whole EP just really rocks. I love how it's produced. Lewis the Child is definitely a really, really good artist that I really should give more attention to. They make some awesome music and I just don't listen to it enough. My favorite song on this one, the most fun one I found, was actually Talk. Really good EP. Definitely check out this one. Neddy's new EP on Fix has some really unique ideas, and I like the theming around this aquatic kind of thing that the first two tracks especially go for. And then after Traction VIP, it just wants to go hard, and I think that's what Neddy really, really, really wants to do with their music. I didn't really have much expectations on this EP. In saying that, I felt like I really enjoyed it, and I probably enjoyed it more than I thought I would. There isn't a bad song on here. The production's pretty good. I think some songs are stronger than the other, but in saying that, still really good. My favourite tune on this one was actually Fiji. Fiji has this really fun future rhythm sound mixed with this tropical sound that the first two tracks go for. I think it's worked really well and has a quite appropriate title. It really feels like a Fiji dubstep song, which is really weird to say. Anyway, really enjoyed this and I'm keen to hear more from Neddy. Mama Yudofu just continues to be in a world of their own. This is just such a fun EP and just exactly what you expect from the name. They're all kind of different songs, but they're all old schoolish kind of. It's a bit kind of chiptune-y, but that's what you expect from Mama Yudofu. It's just another example of the Japanese EDM scene just being really talented, and Mama Yudofu continues to just be a leading force in that. Can't Be Generic is my favourite one, but I still don't know what I'm doing. It's a really great follow-up to the original on Mama Yudofu's latest album, Bootloader. But Can't Be More Generic it's just such a good composer tune. Like, seriously. Of course, yeah, it's not even generic. I don't know why they'd say it's generic, but either way, awesome, awesome stuff. Blosso's new EP on Fix just highlights the problem that I have with Blosso. I just don't hear a distinct sound. The EP's fine, like I actually enjoy all the songs, like none of the songs are bad. They're all dubstep, but they're all like four different styles of dubstep, and none of them sound like Blosso. In saying that though, I don't really know what Blosso sounds like. There's so many different styles that Blosso just crosses over from, that it just doesn't make me excited to hear a Blosso song, honestly. I don't know if that's just me that thinks that, or if it's a really common thought, but either way, that's just what I think. Sad Robot was my favourite on this EP. Colour Bass kind of song was a clear standout to me over the rest, but yeah, not bad. It's just, I just want to know what Blosso really wants to do. Iobarn finally has creative freedom after seemingly leaving the Monster Cat realm of music, and I'm glad because the quality is really showing. I don't really understand the lyrics, I don't know my Japanese well enough to understand, so I can't lyrically connect, but production-wise, really good, and it's furthermore proving that Iobarn is making this style their own. I really like the Resonance remixes on here too. I think it's just TSK, I don't know if you say it is TISK or whatever, but I'm assuming it's just TSK. Was really different and a really creative take of Resonance. But my favorite song on this one is Grayscale. It's the Fritz collab, of course. I think everyone loves that song that I know has heard it anyway. If you haven't heard it, you got to. Hello World has been really busy after just debuting on Monster Cat as well. But after listening to this EP, the variety was just lacking. Each song seems to go for that similar sort of tempo with that distorted bass, and I think it's just part of the alias. I wish there was a bit more variety though. EP's pretty quality, nothing glaringly wrong production-wise, honestly. Nothing horrible, but I can't say I loved it. It's like it's cool, but I don't love it, and there's nothing, I can't identify each song just going, oh yeah, I know that one. The title track was the best one on this, Warning Signs. Not by much. I like Game Over's more dubstep orientated drop as well. That was a pretty good moment on this EP. Beatles was back for their first EP after the album. They're a really fun duo, and I just find that shows in their music. A lot of people give them a hate for it, but I think it's just because they're not, they don't, like, they're obviously serious with their music, but not serious enough to take it to the next level. This EP goes hard for its duration. It's not amazingly unique for Beatles, but they've got that signature sound, and they just got to do whatever they want with this EP. Ghetto Blaster, pretty fun. Brute Force was my favourite. Drop had my favourite drop, but I liked Ghetto Blaster as a whole. Yeah, with the only DMB on this EP as well being on Brute Force as well. My favourite is out of these two for sure. I don't really know how to... Ghetto Blaster was my whole experience, but Brute Force had the best drop, so yeah, there you go. Anomaly is just a true talent and really good for the industry. Good comeback as well. Doesn't make music that anyone else makes, so this has really filled that gap. There's so many funky, clever elements, and just the instruments are just cleverly done. Every tune just feels like it has a purpose to the album, without just, you know, one being pretty lame, but they all feel like they fit, they all feel like full tracks, and you feel like you go back to each one every single time. An album without many lyrical performances with this kind of style usually doesn't seem to hit, but Anomaly didn't really have that many vocals on this one. So it makes every song, like, really impressive, considering it doesn't have, you know, memorable vocals to go with it. It just has the memorable melodies, the piano melodies that Anomaly is just known for. Bond and Come Running to Me were my favourites. Just because they just so fun. Loon was also a good song. I think it's Loon A, but Loon was also a very good song too. Really impressive album. I know that there's a few friends of mine who love Anomaly, and I see what they see. I feel like I've promoted this guy so many times, and he just still doesn't get enough listens. Gemini Child Volume 1 is the first of a sort of series, I think, where it's just kind of ideas that are just put out to the world that never really got finished or something. This is just a really good showcase of every single style that Jeffrey has going on for him. He's really talented. The production is just so fun. He's actually a really good vocalist too, and knows how to work his vocals in with the ideas that he wants, and all the tracks fit here. Samsung's fun, Temptation's really good, and Untouchable is just awesome as well. My favorite's probably Temptation. I feel like the drowned vocals actually really worked, kind of, but Untouchable is also really fun. Please listen to this. I'm definitely sharing Gemini Child Vol 2 when it comes out. One of the most renowned artists in bass music is Martin Garrix, just for the house section. This is a real throwback of the album, completely unexpected because I didn't know this album was even coming out. It's a really great production. I wouldn't say I love it. A few songs are really awesome, and the whole collab theme that was going on for this album, really cool. But the old style sometimes makes some songs just feel too bland because the style's just outdated. I really like Follow with Zed. That was a really surprising song. Funk with Julian Jordan is, as the title says, Reboot with Vla. I've never known how to say Vla's name, but really promising artist, and I'm glad they're getting a lot of recognition now. And also Quantum with Brooks. Good to see Brooks back. Nanu's an artist I recently shared with Emu Master 5 because I think they have a lot of potential. But I think the problem with having a heavy bass album is it feels more like a compilation than an actual like set of ideas and a story. And I think this has that problem. The songs don't really flow from one to another. It feels like a compilation. That being said, great quality. I like a few of the tracks. Nothing really production-wise to fault it for. Yeah, and it doesn't have like amazingly unique ideas, but I think that'll come as Nanu grows. Meet Your Creator is really cool, and I like where Higher goes. Reality Engine with Extra Terra is also a really cool song too, and I like Metaverse as well. I liked Mern's album, and I liked the EP before this, but this shorter EP is honestly my favourite thing that Mern's really come out with, other than the amazing trap days from years ago. This has so much dedication and time put into it, and that's why it took so long to come out. It's really atmospheric, and I love that Mern's improving his vocals each and every time. It just feels like a really fully finished project. There's no gaps or anything. There's catchy, emotional elements in every song, and it's just really cool. I'd honestly recommend any track from this individually. My favourite song is Emotion, but it's followed ever so closely by the title track Circles. And Faithless is really good for having no vocals too. This is a very big recommendation of mine. I'm going to be honest here, not a noisier listener. I just can't get with the project because it's just not in the style I enjoy. That halftime, that drum and bass, I think most people know that it's just not for me. But their influence on the scene is huge, and with this album coming out, I can already see that it's gained some traction. I'm going to be honest, the album's still not for me. I know it's, you know, 2022, you thought, oh, maybe this, nah, it still doesn't fit for me. I'm really happy for everyone, though, that loves this album. I'm sure it's going to be a really big hit, especially because it's their swan song as well. My favourite song on this is not Supersonic VIP, that's my second favourite. It's actually Halcyon. I find Halcyon just goes really hard, and it's definitely a standout for me. Butte Noise is a freak. This EP is just insanely good. Such talent in this. It's just amazing how, like, Butte Noise has barely been around, really. Like, it's been 2 years. There wasn't barely any releases last year. Come to this year, we get another new EP, and it's just crazy good. So many fresh ideas and so many places that this whole EP goes to. It's nothing short of what I expected, honestly. I knew I'd love it. I ended up loving it. It's just so full of so much flavor and life, and it's got that jungle sound that Butte Noise is really, really nailing. It just makes it so, so good. Banana in Your Face is my favorite song. It's a wacky title. It is a wacky song in its own way, but it goes really hard. Butte Noise is going to be a really, really great talent. Finally, an album from Trivecta, and I don't really know what I was supposed to expect going into this, but it kind of came out the way that I don't think I expected to. I thought this was going to be more that melodic dubstep route. In fact, it was literally every route except the glitch hop. So, alright. Has his signature style in his dubstep that everyone knows of, but it has that signature house. He put some trap in here. There was Big Room as well, and a drum and bass song. I appreciate that. It sounds like a compilation and a story, but I just appreciate they went through literally just everything that he makes and even spiced it up a little bit, which is pretty cool. I think the second half of the album, definitely better than the first half of the album, but in saying that, I didn't hate it. Empty Oceans and Back to the Start, two house songs, my favourite. Yeah, pretty confident in saying they're my favourite. Memory Away is my favourite dubstep song. I like Horizon Lines, that's the drum and bass song. And The Gallows, the Big Room song. Yes, I like the Big Room song, it's actually pretty cool. So yeah, Trivecta album, pretty solid. I feel a bit guilty saying this, but I like the Chainsmokers new album. They changed it up, there's a few different things, bit of Weathen production which might have helped out. I liked what it does. The songs don't just have, you know, drop, drop, that's it. Like, it changes up. There's some tempo changes in there, which is just, like, really, really weird to see. But anyways, the songs actually sound distinguishable. Drew's vocals were pretty the best they've ever been. Yeah, I'm impressed. I feel confident in saying that this is the Chainsmokers' best album. I liked Solo Mission. That was really fun. High is the most popular song on the album. I actually love it. I definitely enjoy the vocals and how the whole song kind of flows, and I like that it's probably the best track in terms of being vocal driven rather than Solo Mission, which has like its drops and whatnot. Something Different also had like a future bass drop. That was really cool. That seemed like a throwback to a few years ago, future bass, so it's good to see. Yeah, it'd be a hard album to rank, honestly, so I thought it'd be better off putting it in here. Wide Awake and Dreaming is Mazaire's brand new EP on Ophelia, and I feel really let down by this. Mazaire's had some pretty good songs and has changed up their style a little bit over the years, but come back to this EP and it's just same old structure and just doesn't do anything new. I was hoping that maybe being Ophelia could have done something a little different, like Mazaire would have tried like some even melodic dubs. I wouldn't even care if it was melodic dubstep, like just not drum step. Didn't get that. EP was still drum and bass driven except for one track. Songs aren't bad but really great, and I don't really want to come back to them. Sleepwalker was the only heavy track, ended up being my favorite just because the other ones just feel like a bit drained of life. I'm not coming back to this. Ipsyn has an EP on Circus that is surprisingly really good. I think I enjoyed it more than Ipsyn's album. It's half the tracks, but nearly twice as good in reality. I love that this is the colour base that Ipsyn is capable of. I knew that they could have a project like this and it's come to fruition, and it's really, really good with tight production. I still feel like there's a lot of variety in it. Like, it's all they're all in the realm of colour base, right? But every song felt different, which I think is a credit to Ipsyn, because that's pretty hard to do for a lot of colour base projects, because they can get very same, if you get me. Mirrors, I love that track when it released. It's been in playlists for a bit now. And I actually liked Violet. Violet is going to probably be the most underrated song in this EP, but I feel like it's nearly my favourite, other than Mirrors. Mirrors is great, though. My fellow Aussie Flume, who I'm actually seeing in December, back with a really, really nice album that has that classic Flume sound that you just expect to hear every time. It's got that all over the place sort of production, but yet it still sounds coherent. Really good vocalist. He always manages to get the top vocalist for the job. This album is just exactly what I wanted, really. My favorite on this album is Highest Building, easily. It's the first track, it's the best track, it's amazing vocals. That midsection is just incredible. It's so blissful. Next favorite ended up being Escape with Quiet Bison and Kaka or Kuka. I don't know how they want their name pronounced, but yeah. Highest Building is a huge hit for me. Nothing really to say about We Are Theory's new EP. Got some dark tones to it, but nothing really blew me away. That theming, I guess, was sort of the only thing I really took note of, but in terms of production and the ideas, just nothing really stood out to me as really unique or made me want to come back. No bad songs, again, I would tell you if there was a bad song, but no great songs, I suppose you could say. My favourite on this one was Holy. It's a little bit more interesting than the rest, but it was honestly, each song kind of felt pretty similar to each other in terms of enjoyment, so yeah. AK's new album on Bitbird is really great. Imperfections is exactly what AK's style is built around. It's exactly what they're renowned for, and it stays true the entire time. The production's really great, the melodies are so beautiful. I could really just sit back and relax, and I had to give a fair few tracks their own listen as well, just because I got lost in the music a bit listening to the album as a whole. Favourite song on this is Tiny Molecules of Water, but I think every song is great in its own way, and I really like the outro track, which is also the title track too. new Mad Dubs EP on Halcyon. I wasn't really a fan of this. It's not for me. I wish I liked it more, but it's not for me. But I do appreciate that this style is loved by a lot of people. But in terms of Halcyon music, it's not my favorite style. It just doesn't hit. Four of the five songs felt pretty unimpactful, honestly. And like each song flowed well, though, and that's the main thing. Give this EP credit for. Just doesn't get me moving, and you know, I don't really enjoy it as much as I think the EP wants me to, you know, move around and enjoy the mindlessness of it sometimes. But yeah, favorite song on the EP was DN, which obviously is short for Do Nuts, but I think that one was definitely the easy, most impactful, and flowed the best of the whole EP too. So yeah, definite favorite one there on an EP I wish I liked more. Gemini is Lizdek's brand new self-released album, and honestly, I really enjoyed it. Lizdek's gone for more his heavier style in their music lately, compared to what was happening a few years ago, and I'm honestly fully on board with it. I really like it. As much as I love his melodic stuff, particularly the Bendel collabs, they're just iconic. But yeah, this is looking really promising, and I like that Lizdek's getting on some more recognizable labels, given this is still self-released too. Some really good tunes on it. Some I didn't love as much, which I found some type of Lizdek's trap, but there were some pretty good tunes on this one. In particular, my favourites were Split Avian as well with Joss Lockwood, and I also like Gemini as well. Production on this is really, really good, and I can definitely see myself coming back to this album for sure. A Season of Growth is one of Silkenwood's new compilations. And it's just, again, just showing just what the core artists are just capable of. They've got artists like Euphorian, Katari, who was on Never Say Die before it ended, Eroto, Chalbert, all these guys are just insane right now. And yeah, it's just, they're showing what the EDM labels really should be doing. Just there's compilations, there's unique releases, EPs, singles, just everything on this label seems to be right. And it feels like everything I want a label. Especially with the music quality too, like the quality right now is just insane. The compilation itself, really good, sets a high bar for future compilations, and every song is just produced amazingly, and it's probably my biggest recommendation of the entire video. Voka's song was my favourite, but I also like Eroto and Katari as well. I really disliked how this album came out. I don't like the whole every song releases a single part. That wasn't great. Given that, it's a Jay Kutch album. It's awesome. Every song from start to finish is just amazing. And if I hadn't heard every single beforehand, it would have felt better. But given that, really, really, really good album. He's one of the best producers in the scene, and his vocals are just really nailing at the minute. And yeah, there's nothing else really out there that's like this album, because it's such a unique style and it continues to be really, really unique. His vocals just continue to get better and they suit the songs really, really well. And yeah, every song feels different. Best song on the album though, I think this one's pretty obvious. It's the Adam Tell collab, Maybe. It nearly overshadows Data Loss, which is a really, really, really hard song to top for both of them really, but I think Maybe might have actually done it. Really awesome album. If you hadn't heard any of the singles before this, it's really good to listen to as a whole album. Brand new Former Hero EP, and it's pretty nice. Former Hero has moved on to this more emotional side instead of like this, you know, really fast tempo pace stuff, which I really like, and that's probably why Deepfake actually is my favourite on the EP. Didn't already bring that up. I've probably grown out of Former Hero a little bit. I've just moved on from that style. I still check out every release. It's still really good. I've probably moved on from it just a bit. There's more emotional focus, which I do like, but the faster paced music stuff is just what I really like Former Hero for. And not to say that I don't want him to stop like making the emotional stuff. I actually want him to keep making it, because that's what he wants to make, and I'm fully on board with that. But yeah, Deepfake is just my favorite, just for my personal taste, I think. But yeah, Former Hero probably has an album coming out maybe next year or something. I can't remember. So yeah, good to see where that goes. Convexity's back on Rushdown with a brand new EP, and it's just another showcase of like Convexity's really pushing the color base in the industry. I don't really feel like convexity is like, you know, whoa, these crazy, crazy unique ideas, but they always hit. And compared to what convexity was making like 5-6 years ago when they were running Expanse, this is just, it's insane to see where they've come from, and it's really, really good to see. All the songs in this feel really impactful and quite unique, especially Euphorion and the Kero collab, which is really good to see that, especially good to see Euphorion on Rushdown. But yeah, love all the twists and turns the EP takes too. My picks actually end up being the solo tracks, Timeless and Chimera. Don't know how that worked out, but Spectral Flux was also pretty cool. But yeah, Timeless and Chimera were my favorite two songs. This brand new EP from Charlie W marks Night Owl Collective's return. It's been like 2 years since we've seen Field Trip Volume 4, and we got this EP, and god damn, it's really, really good. What a way to kick things off. Charlie W is an artist I've never heard of before this EP. I didn't know what to expect, and I'm sure as hell following Charlie W now, because this is really, really, really good. The production's awesome. Four completely unique and different songs. This is fun style mixed in every single song. It just fills you with pure jubilation, really. Don't pass this EP up, because I really, really recommend you check it out. My favorite two songs on the EP, my two recommendations would definitely be Laundry and Arborist Dad. But yeah, every song is really good on this. And I'm so, so, so happy to see Night Owl Collective is back. I've never been a big Bainbridge fan. I don't really find Bainbridge's dubstep to really hit for me. It just doesn't have that impact, but I honestly feel like it's not really like unique either. It feels very, very like every single time the structure feels really the same, and the dubstep songs in this EP feel exactly the same. It feels really samey. It hasn't got any standout moments. I still can't really get into the hype of Bainbridge at all. I had one playlist ad on this one. I think it's pretty obvious if you know the EP. It's the Bass House song To The Bassline. It's really heavy. I love how it flows. It's easily my favorite, and I'm glad that something like this is actually on Roundtable. I think Bainbridge still has a lot of work to do in terms of living up to the hype of Disciple signing them exclusively. Over the next couple of years, I really hope that that ends up coming to fruition, but right now, I'm just not seeing the hype of Bainbridge at all. I thought I'd hate New Breed a lot more than I did. It's not too bad. I wouldn't say it's Kazo's best album, and I wouldn't really say it's one of the best albums of this entire video. It's probably still down there a little bit. A lot of heavy tunes, a lot of pretty mediocre and really just harsh tunes on the ears. Lots of dubstep and rock influences in this one, so Kazo's really straight away from that just hard style, hardcore stuff. It can sound really weak with production, or pretty messy and unimpactful, but other times you can make it hit really hard, but it doesn't seem to happen a ton in this album where the songs really hit hard. There's some songs that don't really go anywhere, some that just sound messy, but yeah, there's a few hard-hitting ones. My favourite track was actually the title track, New Breed. It's a huge throwback to This Time by Kazo, his first Monster Cat single. It might be a bit biased because I've been a Monster Cat fan, not sure. But this song is basically a VIP of that song. So the tieback's really, really hooked me. So yeah, easy favorite on that one. And probably a playlist ad. Bear Grylls released a two-part album called Prismata. So this one is gonna be the dark album. All the heavy stuff's in this one. The tracklist, really unflattering, honestly. Doesn't look enticing at all. I don't like the collab names on it. Some look alright, but yeah, I don't like who's on this album. The quality was probably what I expected, and it's just more of a compilation of collabs. No album structure at all. Not horrible, but not really the most, not really amazing highlights, but there was some. I liked that some smaller artists are here, and it wasn't completely a waste of my time listening to this album, but a lot of songs were just dubstep, and there's nothing else to them, and there's no reason to ever come back to them. I like Stomp Machine with Ivory. I'm glad Ivory's on this album. Not a collab I probably expected, but either way, Ivory's here. I like Double Barrel with JQ as well. I've never said JQ, who cares? And Rebellion with Murate as well. That's a good song as well. So yeah, definitely highlights on this one. Rebellion. And now we cross over to Prismata Light, which is the worst one, honestly. Every song here, except for one, has like the same structure. Every single song just sounds so similar. And despite being advertised as a light album, there's still a fair few heavy tunes on here, which I'm surprised are on this version. Regardless, the production is a lot worse than Dark, I think. I think there's a lot less variety, and I think it's really, really a lot more messy ideas and not as unique ideas. There's a heap, lots less variety, and this album actually feels like a flop compared to Dark. So the only highlight on this album, only one song I like, was Good Together, and because it's the only one that's not dubstep, actually changed the formula, and it's kind of fun to listen to. So very, very weak album, but that's my definite highlight. Thinking of doing a video on this one by itself, but I decided to go with this because I'm kind of straying away from doing ranking videos for everything. But Sleepover Volume 2, Silken Woods All Nighter Take. Really great compilation. You really need to hear this one. I know it's popular with a few people already, but if you haven't heard it, definitely need to listen to this one. There's a ton of small underrated talent, and a lot of that pool is where I'm getting a lot of my music from at the minute, which is great. Fans of All Nighter definitely need to listen to this one. I can think of a few people in particular. My favorite tunes on this one, there was a few of them. I really liked Please by Self Discovery and Dishfing, Haptics by Dimitri, Space for You by Alva Gracia, Akian, and Theron is also a really good one too. And the Mega Collabs Hue Shift and Ethernet Restaurant are also really good tunes. That's just five of the 33 song track list. That's just five of them. There's a few other good ones too, and I think I'm going to be featuring a fair few songs from this album in other types of videos I'm doing. I was considering ranking this, but I thought it felt fitting to end this entire video off on a really good compilation that a lot of people need to hear. So yeah, really great project. Definitely check this out, and check Silkenwood out. There's another Silkenwood album in this video, and yeah, Silkenwood is killing it at the minute. You really need to hear them. So that brings us to the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. I had a ton of fun listening to all the projects in this video. If there's anything I missed, which I'm sure there is, please, please, please let me know in the comments. I really, really, really would love to hear everything that come out during the year. And if I've missed anything, I might cover it in a video at the end of the year for any projects I missed during the year. I think it would be really good to do that. I may even open up a forums, or I'm keen on starting a Discord server, honestly. Either way, make sure you check out every project on this video. It's really, 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 really important to supporting all the artists. And I'm keen to keep this series going, so if you want me to keep going, let me know. Thanks guys for watching, and I will catch up with you in another 3 months.